Bazam! Now we're going to react to Childish Gambino, Feels Like Summer. But before that, put on the notification bell, like, subscribe, tell your mama. Let's go.
I think I got flagged last time I tried to play this on my stream, so.
The video? Yeah, we don't need the video. I don't even care about the video. Let's go to the lyrics.
You can fast forward it.
Ah, this is still the video, man. They all use the same video.
Because this video is so good. It's a deep video. You know what I mean? It's a satirical commentary on the music and entertainment business.
Mm-hmm. What the hell is this?
Just go back. Just pause it a few times, you know what I mean?
Okay. Men who made machines that want what they decide. Parents try and tell your children, please slow down. What is this about technology?
Try to tell the children, please slow down.
About technology?
I mean, just in life in general, you know, right? This is a great song, right? It's Marley saying she likes the lyrics. I'm like, yeah, it's okay. Great lyrics.
Okay. You know what I would have liked better in this video? If he weren't wearing earbuds. Because...
What do you mean?
He's going there listening to his music, you know?
That's the point is that all these people are successful in their own right and they have the ability to come together and do something special, but they're all in their own zones. So that's the purpose of him walking through the neighborhood with earbuds.
Uh-huh,
Every single person in the video is an artist. So you see the Migos in there, Jay-Z, Snoop Dogg. He has everybody in there, mm-hmm. And so he's walking through there, and it's like they all, you know what I mean, kind of like stay away from each other when they should come together and do something positive. That's his
thing. I don't care. I didn't notice that there were more artists there.
Every person in there is like an actual somebody. Yeah.
Oh, I love that. Did you play with what is it called? Super Soakers. When you were
Of
young.
course.
That was the shit. I mean, you got the.
See, like this scene right here is describing basically a little bit of what I was getting at with you. He's saying this is why the music is so bad, because the younger kids are basically, they want to get mentorship and kind of connect with the older guys, but the older guys aren't messing with them. So if you notice the Super Soakers, you see like they're going up to the older guys, squirting them or trying to, you know what I mean? And older guys are just like, get away from me, get away from me. You know what I mean? So that's kind of what that
Yeah,
scene
because they're
is
busy
representing
with their
right there.
smartphones and social media and
Or
stuff like
they're
that.
all doing their own thing. And then I think
Yeah.
when they show like Jay-Z and them, Jay-Z and Snoop Dogg and like they're all just like kind of dancing in a row, which is like, it's like they're just like, they're not really doing nothing. You know what I mean? It's like they're just kind of like, enjoying their fucking money, enjoying their, you know what I mean? It's like, anyways,
And also, let me
there's
just
little
say this
subtleties in
though.
there.
Yeah, I agree. I agree. Older, teenagers or whatever back in the days used to interact with our young when we were younger. Like if I was a kid, like 7, 9 years old or something, and some guy was 16 or 17, they would still interact with us back in the day because it was just how it was. Today though,
Go ahead, go ahead.
let's say an older guy wants to interact with kids, he would be seen as a child. You know what? You
Right,
know
right,
what I mean?
right. And there's an interesting, idea to go on there, but it's like, to me, again, like I say, like this is why there's a disconnect with the music, you know what I mean? Because the older guard always shuns the younger guard. They don't try to understand what they're doing and bring them into their world so that way they can evolve to what you're doing. They just shun them. And so then the newer music starts to look at the older music as bad. And then it happens all the way down the line where you have where we're at now, where there's a huge disconnect between classical music and what we have today. Because the classical guys never embraced jazz. The jazz never embraced rock and roll and whatever, whatever. The rock and roll never embraced hip hop. And now hip hop, you know what I mean? So here we are, where nobody is connecting. And anyways,
I
that's
agree.
what this song is slightly about.
I'm part of that. I am.
I've been trying to explain it to you the last few days. You know what I mean?
Well,
In my
you know where
whole,
I'm
not so
coming
good language.
from. You know where I'm
Of
coming
course,
from with
I mean,
that,
but
though.
that's why I'm trying to help you understand the bridge. I'm like, there is a way for us to go from here to there, you know.
I know.
You see, this is the dilemma here.
All right, let me go first. Let me go first. All right. So I do want to hear what you have to say, but just let me soften the blow of you
Well,
saying
this won't
what
be
we
too
know you're
bad,
all,
but
what
yeah.
you're gonna.
I'm back
Well, I mean,
off.
so obviously this is a very simple song. You know what I mean? It's definitely repetitive. With all of Childish Gambino's music, he's trying to get a message out. So he has music that is unmixed, unmastered, that just has one hook and one verse on it, where it's just like he's talking about a situation that he, you know what I mean? So Childish Gambino is on the super artistic side of the game. So when he makes music like this is like him trying to do something a little bit more commercial, but still get his message in there. He wants it to be simple so everybody can hear it and remember it. But then also, anybody who heard the lyrics knows that he's singing about his view on society, that it's like, we should be making progress, but it seems like we're not, in a nutshell. And then, like I already explained, the video is him commenting on what's going on in the music business. You know what I mean? There's like a scene in there with Drake and Future, where it's like Future's riding a bike and Drake is running after him. So, like, me, I'm like, that's him basically talking about what I said when I first played that Future song, right? That everybody in the music business is just trying to copy what Future does naturally. Whether anybody thinks it's good or not, that is what's going on in the music business. So it's like a little commentary like that is what makes this song and this video really powerful. One of my favorite videos. As soon as it came out, I probably watched it like 5 or 6 times that day, just trying to get everything that was going on in the video. You know what I mean? And I still like this song. I listen to it every day. This is one of my son's favorite songs. You know, it's one of those songs that I play for my young son, and he remembers it. He's like, "Oh, I like that song." You know what I mean? So, very, very good song. I give this song like around an 8.8, 8.9. Like I said, it's not too complicated. It's very simple, but he is trying to get that message out there. Shout out
Yeah.
Childish, man.
Yeah, if I would have heard this without maybe the lyrics, I wouldn't have l liked it more. I mean, I like it more while seeing the lyrics. But I will say this, it got me, you know, into the mood. It was a little bit repetitive, but I like his intention behind the song and the lyrics, that he wants to change the world and it, but it's not seemingly changing. So, but my thing I wanted to say is the dilemma here is he wants the world to change, and I know there's auto tune here, but I have a point with this. How can we keep humanity intact if we're going more and more towards robotics? You know what I mean? Like, even with the vocals, because, and I want to say this is like a paradoxical thing. Maybe he can't sing that well. I don't know. Maybe he can. Maybe he can't. I don't know. Maybe he needed autotune to be able to do this song. So if autotune wasn't here, then maybe he couldn't have done this song. But at the same time,
Yes.
doing this song, he wants to change the world or change how people are acting. Meaning, you know, changing how they're going into technology and being kind of numb. It's like weird because I believe if we're gonna go back to humanity, we need to bring humanity back. But if we're doing that with robotic voices, it's not gonna connect, at least not get that effect that he wants. So it's like, but if it wasn't for autotune, he might have not been able to do this song. So it's like it jams.
It's yeah, I mean you see where my struggle is at. That's why I'm like, although I agree with you that certain stuff is better, I can't turn my back on the other stuff. I just can't do it, you know, because there is some
Well, I'm not
important
saying you
music out
should.
there.
I'm not saying you should. I'm just saying it's a dilemma here. So, you know,
As the way you raised.
we're becoming more numb and yeah.
I mean, I don't think anybody could disagree with that. Yeah, I don't think anybody could. Yeah, Childish Gambino definitely uses a lot of tech on his voice. He's a guy that comes from
So
an
why
acting
not try to
background.
learn to sing better? You know what I mean?
Well, he sings pretty good, but I'm just saying like he's not he like he was famous when I was in high school for doing like skits on YouTube. He's
Yeah.
like an actual guy that was an original skit guy, and then he went full-fledged music. But he wasn't like he didn't do it for fake, you know. I mean, he like went
Yeah.
full fledged, and he put out like you know. So
Let me
of course,
just.
all the beginning was all auto tune, and then you know, obviously slowly he's developing himself to a better singer, you know.
Let me
So in
just
the
bring
beginning, it was just
this.
like complete auto tune.
Yeah, let me just bring this to you because I'm still not. I don't know where you're at with this exactly. So you think it doesn't matter if a human voice is pitch corrected or not, right? Not going long into it. I
No,
just.
not that it doesn't matter. I don't. Of course, it matters, right? But I don't think that it's bad.
No. But
It
I,
does
what I'm trying.
matter, but I don't think it's bad.
What I'm trying to get to is when you feel a vocal, in my book, it has to be human. Otherwise, I can't feel it. And listen, I might think it sounds good, just like the song we did, Falsia, the other day for your release. Yeah, it sounds good, but I'm not feeling it. I'm not feeling her voice.
No, I don't have that same reaction. No, I don't have
Yeah.
that same reaction.
But
I can feel. I feel T-Pain songs all the time.
even though it's
Yes,
like robotic.
T-Pain has some of my favorite music. Period.
Yeah, but music, I'm
Period.
talking
It's not
about
even
vocals.
close.
I'm talking about
I
vocals
feel
here.
the song. The song
Okay.
hits me. Yes.
So,
Yeah, the
okay.
song hits me.
If I bring it to Michael Jackson, let's say they auto-tuned his voice. Would you notice it? Or would you feel the difference?
That's a different thing. I'm like, of course I would notice, but we're saying like, would I feel it or would I not feel it? If the song was good and there was meaning to the song, like obviously I like my songs to have meaning to it. You feel me? Whether you think the meaning is good or bad, I need, yeah, that's gonna make me feel the song. What makes me feel that song that we just listened to? Well, remember I told you, I'm like, I heard the song. And he dropped the video the same day. So he dropped the song with the video. That's why you only see it with the video. So it
Well,
was the video plus the song that made me feel it. You know what I mean? It wasn't just a song. Video,
yeah,
song,
but
lyrics.
that means that maybe the lyrics or the video and
But
other stuff makes you feel it. But I'm
it's
talking
all part
about,
of it, though.
yeah, I'm talking about plainly the vocals of a singer. Like, do it need to be human, or can you still feel it while it's being roboticized? Because I do not feel the human voice when it becomes roboticized.
Well, I'm like, we're gonna close it out with this, and you can
Yeah.
give your rating, all right?
Yeah, I'm gonna give
To
it a rating.
me, feeling, right, emotion takes place in the brain. I determine how I feel at every moment of the day, even though I can use certain catalysts to help jumpstart me into certain feelings. The feeling is all 100% dependent on me and what I decide to feel. So I can not hear any music and still feel the way that I'm feeling with the music on. I can imagine. You know what I mean? I can imagine Michael singing, and it's the same brain activity as if I'm really hearing him sing, you know. So that's why I don't put too much credence on the actual thing itself. You know, the feeling is what I'm going for, and I can recreate the feeling from nothing.
Okay. Well, I'm just talking about
So what was your score?
if we're gonna change the world back to human, we have to look at that. Anyways, my score is, I'll give it a personal score, I'll give it a 5.5, but in this type of music, I'll give it
That's pretty good.
7.9. Yeah. All right.
You were
Bazaar!
close. Yeah, you were close. Oh, the real
Huh?
rating is an 8.8, 8.9.
Okay. Bazaar!